I used to get the run around. I've been doing this since I had to work at mama house. Tear down, tear down, tear down, tear down, tear down. Everybody eating, it's a party when I come to town. You can bring your mama, daddy, sister, and your cousin out.
Gone down and the mercury going down as well. To be expected, I guess, here on an autumn night just outside of D.C. at FedEx Field. Tonight, we've got a great Sunday night matchup between the Baltimore Ravens and the Washington Commanders. So the regular season down. What will the final two bring us as we're off in week nine? And he is out of bounds as they'll start up past the 30. Scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And right away, they're going to stack him up right at the line of scrimmage. Throwing on second down, Powell, and he fires one incomplete.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap, and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
So now an early third and 10 here on their opening drive. Throwing on third down here. That's complete. Terry McLaurin with it. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. They'll go play action. Howell. That's going to be caught by. And oh, he coughed it up. And it's picked up by the Ravens. And he's able to take this one back to the 36-yard line. And hopefully for both sides, not a sign of things to come, Charles. This morning, it was so perfect outside, but we knew this weather was coming, and we see the effects of it here early on.
And I wonder if how perfect it was this morning has psychologically fooled everyone. You know, it's almost like even though we were told the weather was coming, and you know the teams knew it as well, that maybe they got fooled and thought, it's going to be okay. And now they're probably a little upset that it's out there.
Those warm-ups were dry.
Oh, well, dry, and now you've got to make the change up, and it's the first quarter. It might take them a little time to settle in on their focus and concentration.
From midfield now, here's Jackson. He's going to launch this thing way downfield. Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. And in for touchdown. Justin Tucker for the extra point. He hasn't missed an extra point all season, and he won't miss this one either, and it's 7-0. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And they've got it up past the 35, so pretty good starting field position. Washington offense at the line and ready to roll. They had the fumble on the last drive, wound up leading to the opening touchdown. Now they'll try again here, first and 10. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down. So now they have to contend with second and 13 after the first down run goes backwards. Off play action, it's Howell. That's caught by the big tight end, Dallas Goedert. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. It's his first catch, and it'll be good for 15 and a first down. Faking the handoff, Howell. There goes a deep ball, end zone. And incomplete on the deep ball.
Almost feels like anything you can do, we're going to try and match or do better. We've already seen one touchdown pass from the opposition. They tried to equal it on that throw.
They find some open field here. Touchdown, Washington!
Earlier in the week when they had their scouting report meeting, this was the explosiveness that they talked about trying to contain. They were concerned about it all week, yet he still did it to them. Wonder how that's going to carry over the rest of the game.
The point after through the raindrops, up and good, and we are tied at 7. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And we'll see a return here from the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. 3-5 is where they sit on the year. A very uneven start is certainly not an ideal position to be in at the halfway point of the season. CD, do you see an avenue where they can still be a playoff team, or is that ship sailed?
Well, since you took me to the nautical side, I'm going to try and keep up here because, to me, this ship is about ready to pull out of port. These next couple of games are absolute must-wins for them. Now, if they can win a couple, get to 5-5, maybe they start believing in themselves. But a loss here, that would move me 3-6. And if that's the case, well, that boat is going to head out to the harbor with them still on the dock.
And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, 2nd and 2. Off the play fake, here's Jackson. Looking left sideline, incomplete.
Now this defense for the Commanders, they were very strong last week in that win over Cleveland.
And that's not the half of it. They forced 7 turnovers in that game, and I know we always talk about turnovers coming in bunches once you force the first one. But 7? That seems almost impossible, but we watched it happen.
They go play action with Jackson. That's going to be caught. And he is into the end zone for a Baltimore touchdown.
With Shaq Bateman.
2 catches, 2 touchdowns here so far. And the Ravens have taken the lead. Tucker with the extra point, and that makes the score 14-7. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape, up past the 30.
out there set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense.
And, you know, it's certainly a lot of football left to play. We're not into December yet, but right now where we stand, they're in first place in their division, looking really good. And he fumbled it. It's on the ground, and it's picked up by the Ravens down the right sideline. And they will finally get him, but not until he's all the way down inside the 15-yard line. And maybe that one caused by the weather. Of course, the rain coming down. Charles, can you maybe, when you're carrying that football, grip it too tight in the rain?
I think that you can, and it's such a delicate balance, too, because when you grip it so tight, sometimes it'll slip out from your body. You squeeze it too hard, and it'll pop out on its own. I've actually had running backs talk to me about that, that when they've tried too hard, even in perfect conditions, the ball gets away from them. They've got to find that good balance, carrying it firmly, yet at the same time under control.
Again on second and 10, it's Jackson. Throw right side here, taken in by Bateman. And the Ravens are looking at first and goal as he's tackled all the way down at the 2-yard line.
And remember, this drive started off following the turnover, and they've taken no time working their way down the short field. A nice connection there, and now they're looking at a first and goal.
They go play action now. Jackson. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Montez Sweat, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year.
And that's their first sack of this game, but how about last week? 6 sacks, great coverage downfield, which helped that pass rush. They are really working in sync right now.
It's second and goal, but now all the way back at the 14. No. Another try after the first down sack. Jackson, and it's caught. Touchdown! Mark Andrews with a lucky number 13 touchdowns now on the year. And the Ravens go up by 2 touchdowns. Tucker able to connect on the extra point, and it's now 21-7.
Ravens 21, Commanders 7.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And they're going to wind up with pretty good starting field position as they get it up past the 35. Trying to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. And they'll bring the big tight end across the formation left. On first down, Howell. He completes this one to Terry McLaurin. And he's finally taken down. And it's a big game there. Going to use one of their timeouts. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. They'll throw on first down. Here's Howell. Hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
Now they go play action with Howell. This to McLaurin out on the left side. Touchdown, Washington! Terry McLaurin, 40 yards, and the Commanders are back within a score.
I think if you pulled defensive backs, they would say the corner route, take that out, make it illegal, because that is so hard to recognize and so hard to adjust, because your first move is to not get beat in the middle of the field. And that's how they move.
Oh, and now they're going to fake it. And he's across for 2 points. What a gutsy call right there, but the fake works. And they get the 2 instead of 1. Joey Sly now to kick off after the touchdown. This is taken way up at the 25. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And thus far, the weather has not slowed this offense down one bit. They've looked good so far in the first half.
They certainly have. And think back to our meeting with the head coach. And we asked him, because we saw the forecast for this game, didn't we? We said, hey, have you prepared for this? And he talked about the different drills that they've done in adverse conditions, the wet ball drills, things of that nature. He said, I don't think it's going to slow us down much. We tend to handle it pretty well. And he's been right.
Play action. It's Jackson. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
And partner, to me, that one was all about timing. If he's there too early, it's going to be a pass interference call. If he's too late, it's a completed pass. He was Johnny on the spot on that one.
So after the incompletion on first, now 2nd and 10. Play action. Now Jackson. Complete. In Washington territory now. Here's 1st and 10 at the 36. Now Jackson. Got a man. It's caught inside the 10. And finally down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. Throwing is Jackson. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
Let's give this defense some credit now. They let the guys get downfield. But when push came to shove, they stood their ground. Now they'll likely force a field goal attempt.
They'll try again here from the 7 on 2nd and goal. Again, Jackson. And oh, it'll be intercepted. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And the Commanders are going to get the football here as the ball will come out to the 20. But turnovers, obviously, Charles, always costly. But, man, when you throw those interceptions in the end zone like that, it really stings.
He tried to fit that one into his tight end, and I often use the expression NFL open, which means a tighter window. Down near the goal line, you really want him to be open. In this case, it cost him.
But he certainly didn't like what he saw all from the coverage on his primary reads, and he didn't even have any luck trying to get back to his safety valve. Give defense a credit. Coverage was in lockdown mode everywhere.
They try to throw on 2nd down, but this one is incomplete.
Well, they approached this drive with a lot of confidence after their last one ended up as a touchdown. But incompletions on their first 2 throws has them huddling up and trying to figure out a big play here on 3rd down to get their momentum going again.
Now they face a 3rd and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Howell from the gun. And that will be incomplete.
Give them credit for excellent coverage, tight coverage. They're doing a lot of things that we talk about in basketball. They're causing disruptions in the passing game. And as long as that continues, it'll be tough for them to gain any momentum throwing the ball downfield.
Going for it on 4th. Here's Howell. And it's going to be batted down. It will go the other way with a football. A surprising move to go for it predictably, at least somewhat predictably. It doesn't pay off. And now possession's going to go over with a football at the 20-yard line. Here's a handoff out of the gun. And he's only going to get a yard from the 20 to the 19. The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. Here's Jackson. And that went too far in front. He couldn't reel it in. It's incomplete.
They love to try to take advantage of his height, and I wouldn't be surprised to see them try to run it back and try it again, maybe with a little less mustard on the throw.
He finds Sutton crossing the formation complete. They'll try and throw for it with Jackson. He's going to have his running back. It's complete. And in for the Ravens touchdown. An 11-yard touchdown. And the Ravens' decision to go for it pays off with 6 points. So the call's made by Sean McVay. They're going to go for two. Jackson here, he's going to look to throw. And this is going to be caught. It's good. And that extends their lead by two more. And the formula there on the two-point try to go five wide, not even the option to hand the ball off. They got it.
They tried to create space, and there isn't a whole lot of it there. For the defense, what you're trying to do is make sure that if someone, if they're going to catch the ball, make them catch it behind you because they run out of space with the back line. But in this case, the offense figured it out.
The Washington offense at the line and ready to roll. And this is not an easy situation. You're down early, in the elements, you're on the road. How do you get the mojo back?
Well, one thing is to remember that as an offensive player, you have a much better idea of what you're trying to accomplish and where you're trying to go than the defender. So in this case, because you know it, you can make your cuts with a little more decisiveness. Maybe a second fake, some double moves, things of that nature, to go ahead and try and put some pressure on the defense.
And he'll be brought down just shy of the 40. The play fake, and now here's how to throw it. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive, not much since. Powell looking to throw again. It's caught on the right side by Robinson. And he's going to be taken down with the first down at the Ravens' 29-yard line. First down, Howell to throw. This one hauled in, and again it's Robinson. And he'll be out of bounds just inside the 25-yard line. Calling a gain of 6 on the play, and that'll make it second down. Second down and a run by Robinson. And they're knocking on the door now. There's a good run there. Going to take this to about the 10-yard line. Back to Robinson now on first down. And so close. He gets it to the one. Out of bounds right there. 72 yards for him on the ground so far tonight as he has been terrific in this first half. Keep in mind they can still get a first down here as they come up on second and inches. And he'll get nothing out of that one.
Okay, I'll admit it. I'm a little surprised by that call. Second and inches. It did what it was intended, but it felt like it was a free play waiting to happen. I thought they might take a shot.
On the QB sneak, and this time he breaks the plane. He's in for the touchdown. The sneak successful from a yard out, and the Commanders have got it back to within a score. Extra point by Sly is up and good, and that'll cut the lead down to a touchdown. Joey Sly now to kick off after the touchdown. From way up at the 23.
And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive as they take over with exactly 1 minute to go. They'll start on the ground here on first down. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. From the 41, Jackson. And this is going to be hauled in by the tight end, Andrews. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Ravens touchdown. Rashad Bateman, as the first half is winding down. And the Ravens would extend their lead here just before halftime. They'll look to throw. And he fires one that's intercepted. And he's got daylight. It's a foot race.
Well, there's some excitement, right? Go for two. And instead, it gets picked off. And how about the return? Give him a lot of credit, though, for not giving up after the play.
Yeah, the troops rallied.
Exactly. Getting back there and making the tackle and not giving up 2 points themselves.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away from the 10. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22.
Washington takes over first down at their own 22-yard line.
Out there set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense.
And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
On first and 10, it's Robinson.
And he's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds. We've seen him break off a big run already in this game, and for a second, that one looked like it might be another.
Yeah, I think that any defense would say, look, we can't let him get to the second level, because sometimes he'll break off the big run on his own, but oftentimes you get additional blocking in the second level, which gets you deeper into the secondary.
So we've reached halftime in a wild first half. We'll take a minute to catch our breath as we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando. That's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. Forecast calling for more of the same. The rain set to continue as we are underway in the second half. This is taken just shy of the 10. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30, up to the 33. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And the points, they have come fast and furious in this quarter.
You really don't want to be on the defensive side of the ball right now, do you? Because you're either thinking my replacement may get an opportunity.
Your head better be on a swivel.
Totally. Or maybe I just need to get out of the game for a while because I just can't slow these guys down. They've got to figure out a way to disrupt these offenses. And typically, one guy makes a big play, and that can help change things.
They'll be looking for disruption on both sides right now. Looking to throw on second down. Jackson. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Chase Young. What persistence, and that persistence pays off. Tracks him down for a 19-yard loss. After that sack, it's third and long for Jackson and the Ravens. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. And the throw
Those two just haven't been in sync thus far. They've done a nice job against him, but still, with his talent, you would expect him to have more completions to him in this game.
Fourth down, here's Jackson. And he's brought down. Can't do anything with the football. It's a sack and a turnover on downs. Boy, a real head scratcher there. And Washington will take control of the football in great field position. Hand off to Robinson out of the shotgun. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine. Off play action, it's Howell. He finds his tight end, Goddard. That's complete. And he'll be taken down at about the 22-yard line.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there, freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
Third and one. Howell's going to throw it. On the move to his left. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Now we've got whistles here before the snap, and I believe this is going to be on Washington. Field goal unit and Joey Sly now.
He was true on his first. This a tough one from 49 yards away.
Sly able to put this one through,
and this is back down to a 7-point game.
So given three on that drive, and, you know, normally you'd say we'll take it, but the way points have been flying around, it feels like a little bit of a letdown.
Yeah, you just have to wonder, are field goals going to be enough? Because as you pointed out, the way touchdowns have been scored, does kicking a field goal actually put you at a disadvantage the rest of the way?
I'll tell you, far from ideal conditions to play in, but neither offense has had much trouble. Plenty of points to go around. First and 10.
Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8. Off the play fake. Here's Jackson. Going for the deep ball. He's got a man complete.
And he's brought down here just outside of the 20. So give him the yardage on the completion and also tack on 15 more.
If you give that hand up there, you've got to let go immediately or just not close the hand at all. He didn't, gave it a tug, and that was easy for the officials to see.
They go play action now. Jackson forced out to his left. And he is into the end zone for a Baltimore touchdown. A great play there. His first touchdown on the year. And the Ravens are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. A nice connection there, finding his target, and that'll put six up on the board.
Just like they drew it up in their playbook and reiterated it on the sidelines, right? Perfect route, a good throw, and the defense, they had no answer for that right there.
Tucker with the extra point, and the lead now up to 14. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. The Washington offense at the line and ready to roll. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
They're looking for the big chunk now because...
And now a fumble. The ball's out. And it's picked up by the Ravens. And he's got Rome. And this is going to be brought back for a Baltimore touchdown. The offense, they've had some sloppy moments. Sloppy there again on that one, and it could be the backbreaker.
From a defensive perspective, if the offense is going to be sloppy, you've got to take advantage of that, and that's what they've done all game long.
Tucker able to connect on the extra point, and the lead now to three touchdowns at 21. 49.
Commanders 28. Justin Tucker in the kickoff for Baltimore.
So here's the kickoff now as he'll get it again following that fumble return for a score.
The Commanders take over first down at their own 32-yard line.
Out there set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off,
he's got a man complete. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Faking the handoff, Howard. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
In the third quarter here in D.C., a second and 10 upcoming.
Howell, another throw on second down. And looking for McLaurin, but this is intercepted. Picked off by Jalen Armour-Davis. And now to the races down the right side, and he will bring this back. It's a pick six and a Raven touchdown.
And Charles, for this offense, those interception woes they kind of had in the first half have now followed them into the second half, and for this defense, they take advantage, turn that into a pick six.
And that defense is in a spot now where they're thinking about ways to close this game out. As confidently as they've been playing, I expect them to do exactly that.
Tucker with the extra point, and that'll increase their lead to 28. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away.
Washington takes over first down again at their own 30-yard line.
The Washington offense at the line and ready to roll.
Well, this has been a tough one for them, Charles. They've struggled really on both sides of the football. And one thing that's really plagued them, the turnovers. They've had issues keeping the football in their possession.
And he rifles one that's intercepted. Kyle Hamilton picks it. So their woes on offense continue. That's the second pick thrown here in the third quarter.
And we know it was ill-advised, but that was an opportunity to help them get back into the game. Instead, he throws another interception, and now their task is even tougher.
After the interception, here's Jackson. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Ravens touchdown.
Rashad Bateman,
27 yards.
And the Ravens get another third quarter touchdown to add on to that lead.
So the call's made by Sean McVay. They're going to go for two. They'll try and throw for it. And this is going to be caught. Well, not sure about the need to go for two, but they get it and extend this lead out even further. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown.
Washington will take over the first down again at their own 32-yard line.
Out there set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. Well, we're still in the third quarter, so there's some time to kind of clean this up and make it look more respectable now. A win, that's probably gone out the window, Charles, but I don't know. Do you look at this as a time to just improve and maybe start to look towards the future?
I think you have to find something to play for, something to grasp onto until the clock runs out. But, Brandon, we've been around this game a long time. This is an outlier. You don't get many blowouts like this no matter how the game looks on paper going in. This one has turned out to be everyone's worst nightmare realized.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. And the Raven pressure too much. Down he goes. Carlton Davis speeds in for the sack on the corner blitz.
It's been a tough one all game long for this offensive line. They're already down big, and now you know they're just going to come after the quarterback in a big way, don't you?
Yeah, they just can't get out of their own way right now. It's created an avalanche, and an avalanche is coming right on top of them.
Fourth down, Howell. That's going to be caught by Samuel. He's got room past the 30. Then he will finally be taken down. But how about that play? It's a big one on the final act of the third quarter. One quarter remains here on a Sunday night. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up first and 10. Straight ahead, it's Robinson. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5. Here's Hal to throw on second down. This one complete down the field to Goddard. Touchdown, Washington! Dallas Goddard, 42 yards. And the Commanders get a small measure of revenge as they cut into this fourth quarter deficit. And they're going to get the two-point conversion caught in the end zone. And that cuts the lead a bit further. Joey Sly now to kick off after the touchdown. A short kick taken at the 18. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And they've got to be feeling very comfortable and confident here with this lead in the football here in the fourth quarter, Charles. And I don't think that they need to score again, but it seems like this offense is just getting better as the game goes on. They've scored on their last two drives.
Certainly feels like a chance for them to continue to have some fun out there, doesn't it? Game's already decided, as you noted. So they can continue to play loose, break out some other concepts, maybe run a few trick plays, get other people involved. Heck, even go deep on one of these first snaps just because they can.
And this is going to be caught. So add two more to the lead as they continue to pour it on here in the fourth. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. This one taken just inside the 10. Oh, a dangerous return man showing it here. And he'll be out right at the 35. The Washington offense at the line and ready to roll. Now, this game went off the rails early for them and never really got back on track. And these fans, they were expecting to be on the other side of the scoreboard, but that is not the case as we play on here in this fourth quarter. And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
Even with such a big lead late, the effort hasn't lapsed one bit. If the offense wants to score some points in this one, they're going to have to earn it. These guys are not giving up anything.
To throw on second and 10. Howell over the middle, complete to Samuel. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. In motion goes the tight end. They'll go play action. Howell slings this deep from McLaurin. And this is caught inside the 5. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1 yard line. And Howell will throw it. Dotson has it. Touchdown, Commanders. A 1 yard touchdown pass. And the Commanders are able to eat in just a bit to this sizable deficit. Well, that's just how they drew it up, CD. His first read was there, got it to him quickly, and into the end zone.
Absolutely excellent execution by all involved. And the coordinator, gotta give him credit.
found the perfect play call. Quarterback let it fly as soon as the target came free, and his guy made a nice catch. Just how you draw it up in practice and then execute it in the game.
And this one recovered by the hands team for the Ravens. Now they're down big here in the fourth. They had to try the onside kick. Can't fault them for the effort at least.
No, you can't at all. And if nothing else, now you've put something that you're trying to practice, right, that you've worked on into a game situation. And now you can go back and dissect it. So if you need it again sometime, maybe you'll find a better way to do it. But, yeah, this game's pretty much done for now.
Meanwhile, they take a shot to start the drive, but this is going to wind up incomplete. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Play action. It's Jackson. Oh, looking for Andrews downfield. Got a man. It's caught for a Ravens touchdown. Mark Andrews with his 14th touchdown of the year, second of the game. And the Ravens look like they're going to get back in the win column as they extend their lead here in this fourth quarter. Throwing is Jackson. And this is going to be caught. So add two more to the lead as they continue to pour it on here in the fourth.
Commanders 44. Justin Tucker in the kickoff.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. Takes it at the 7. And he brings us out past the 20 to the 24.
Washington takes over first down again at their own 24-yard line.
Out there setting ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. Where we stand right now in the fourth quarter, this one pretty much out of reach. And Charles, I know they're going to be disappointed about several things with this ball game, but the self-inflicted wounds, they've had several turnovers. You have to think that's going to be something they're going to discuss heavily in the film session in the coming days.
Yeah, absolutely right about that, partner, because they're going to have to sit in that film room and watch every error that they made and figure out how to not do it in the future. And mentally, I think a lot of...
And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Kyle Hamilton picks it, and the Ravens are going to take possession of the football. Well, they've got the huge lead. Now they have another interception on the defensive side. Seems like everything they touch in this one, Charles, turns to gold.
And they have to be awfully happy right there to get what appears to be one more for the road and help seal away one of their best efforts of the season.
And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down. Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle. He's going to look deep down the field. And this is intercepted, but they'll say out of bounds. So very close to a turnover there in the end zone. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. That is caught right at the 10-yard line. They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. He pushes forward for maybe 3 down to the 6-yard line. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Raven football here as we welcome you back. They come up here with another shot from the 6-yard line, and it's second and goal now. And despite the late lead, Jackson to throw. And he will not make it back to the line of scrimmage as he's going to be taken down. Well, they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is third and goal. To throw is Jackson. And give him another 6. It's caught for a touchdown, and the blowout continues. So still throwing here in the fourth quarter with a pretty sizable lead, and now that lead even more sizable. And if nothing else here, CD, a chance to pile on some stats before this one wraps up, and he did just that.
Brandon Convention tells us it's time for them to get off the gas a little bit, right? But you and I both know the receivers don't want them to because, as you noted, this is their chance
to pile on the stats. If they got their way, they try to get every single spot in the depth chart points before this game is over.
And he won't quite make it to the 25. The Washington offense at the line and ready to roll.
Well, this game, it has had no shortage of offense. They've been able to put up a decent amount of points on this side, Charles. They just have not been able to keep pace with the other offense they're going against here.
Yeah, that's a good way of pointing things out, because now it's not a total loss, because as you said, they've scored some points, so there's some plays they can build on, moments where the game plan actually worked. But overall, though, they were just out personnel. They were going up against a team that's playing at an elite level.
He's going to let it fly. And that's caught inside the 35. And somewhat of a measure of revenge as he's in for the touchdown, but they still trail big time.
He'll take it, but he won't be able to smile about it. And yeah, that touchdown counts for their team, but I think it counts more for the fantasy guys, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's just something maybe positive to look at on film, but this one's over, let's be honest.
Yeah, I agree with you totally on that one.
In motion, the tight end. Powell throwing for it. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Now he's into the clear. He's at the 40, 20, 10, 5. And he takes it all the way back. It's a pick two, if you will, as head play backfires in a big way. Joey Sly now to kick off after the touchdown. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive.
And this game, it could very well turn out to be the shocker of the weekend. Not too many expecting them to come in here and win. And they're not just winning, they're dominating. And now trying to finish this one off.
They take a shot downfield there, but it winds up falling incomplete. Ball on the 30 as they come up second and 10. Oh, Jackson's going to throw it. And that is incomplete.
Partner in the sportsmanship handbook, there's something to be said for calling the dogs off in a blowout. But these defenders, they also know this is the NFL, and it's their job to stop them, whether they're in the game or they're down by a handful of touchdowns.
He's going to let this one go deep. All right, rifles one, and it's going to be intercepted. And the Commanders are going to get this back to their own 34-yard line. Keep in mind, he had the 3-interception game last week, so we requested to talk with him this week. He was all smiles. He's still all smiles.
Yeah, we didn't jinx him at all, did we?
No.
Because ordinarily that happens, things fall off, but not in this case. I think a lot of it goes back to his technique, his ability to see the quarterback throw the ball by understanding where the receiver is running his route. Allows him to make a lot of plays on the football, and he's taking it away at a really high rate.
A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. Slot man moves right. Robinson up the middle. And he couldn't quite get there. Tackled down at the one.
Washington now going to use the first of their three timeouts as they get it with 16 seconds remaining on the clock.
Powell. And that is caught. Well, they're going to see this one to the end. They get a score, but pretty much an exercise in futility right now. Still down big.
And Charles, they continue to have trouble stopping him as he's into the end zone yet again.
Yeah, that's multiple series now that have ended with him in the end zone. A perfect plan on how to utilize him best when they get in close.
They'll look to throw. And this is caught, so they do get the two. Still a very large deficit, but maybe something to feel a little better about.
Joey Sly now to kick off after the touchdown.
And a fair catch signaled for and taken just outside the 20-yard line. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive.
Well, they came into this one with a vision, Charles, and it has played out exactly as they had hoped, if not even better. They've got the huge lead here, and now the football for the final moments of the fourth.
Yeah, and it was apparent that they were the better team, right?
He's got a man complete.
And the tackle going to be made at the 38.
And here come the whistles and a timeout with 7 seconds left. So now they're going to send out the field goal unit to, as they say, fire away from long distance. And he has got it from 55 yards away. That was never in doubt. And that will extend their lead even further.
So they hadn't called on him at all until this point, but he comes through here and buries one from long range.
Yeah, that's awfully impressive because usually kickers like to get that first one out of their system in the first quarter, sort of get them into the flow of the game. But to come in this late and knock it down from long distance, give him a lot of credit.
Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of a anecdotal type of a number, kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
Powell with one final shot.
And he completes this one to Terry McClure. And a little bit of a consolation prize there. He's into the end zone. Won't win him the game, but they do get the score with all zeros showing.
But some fantasy players are really happy with that score.
Doesn't affect the outcome, but hey, nice job there to put it in the end zone for the final play.
Could it affect other things? Sometimes these types of scores are ones that we don't consider big at the time. Then later on we find out maybe that was a tiebreaker.
Yeah.
Or, of course, in the fantasy football world, these points mean a lot.
A lot there. And this is going to be intercepted.
Picked up by Jalen Armour-Davis.
See, the guys on the other side of the ball had some pride, too. They stopped the two-point play, even though, as you noted, it did not matter. So both teams battled to the end.
So for the Ravens, it's an important win for their postseason hopes as they at least get back to 4-5. And they'll get another road date next week as their opponents will be the New York Jets.
Meanwhile, for the Commanders, the loss will drop them to 6-2 now on the year.
And they'll be on the road next week as they get a date with the Jaguars in Jacksonville. We'll be right back.
Big baby slide through in that drop top. Something by Ben's looking cute. That's fine as her and her friends. Big blinks and snatch waist. Yeah, she brought the ain't no way. Somebody daddy ain't gonna give her the spins. What her ends, cause yeah, she did it. She did it again. A few more tracks and this time she bought friends. Big baby on her way up and showed the steps to a man's. Now salute the general. TGLX got plans, y'all. Yeah. Damn, it's the intro. Yes, it's the intro. Damn, this is the intro. Yes, it's the intro.
They don't know what the info. If we coming like this on the intro, what they here for? If they want the heat, you know who to send for your info. Buy my money like Venmo. This music don't work out. I know how to get it from my ends low. How you feel though? Cause hey, they can't rock with us. Galaxy ain't no stopping us. They ain't trying to steal my style. I'm feeling like I just shopping. Can't trust him cause he numbing. Cause we worried about getting figures. I'm a ain't father figures. Just know my quick to pop it.
Damn, it's the intro? Yes, it's the intro. Damn, this is the intro? Yes, it's the intro. Damn, it's the intro? Yes,